Hello, so in this video I would like to speak about Ram Bahadur mystery which was hidden from you long, but in the recent years he came out with his real face. And yes, I was also one of you who had been fooled, so I cannot claim that I knew what was his plan from the very beginning. But it started to be clear to me, obviously, as soon as he kidnapped me and I became his victim. But in this video, let me speak about how Ram Bahadur, the Maitreya Buddha, who claims himself to be Maitreya Buddha, actually hates Buddha. Now, slowly in the recent years, especially after the rape case of Gangamaya came out, Buddhist lamas, Buddhist monks also came out in the Nepali media or YouTube channels, and they speak out against Bomjon. What they say about Bomjon is that he is not Buddhist, and not only that, Bomjon himself told them face to face already, some of them already back in 2009, that I am not a Buddhist, but they were seeing how he was always breaking every Buddhist rule, every Shila, starting with the Pancha Shila and starting with the rule of non-violence, ending with the basic rules of not killing, because we know that Bomjon had been accused of killing at least four, five, if not more people, because there are six disappeared nuns and monks who are probably, who are feared to be killed. One of them had been witnessed to be killed. So Bomjon hates Buddha. Bomjon hates Buddha so much that currently the Buddhist lamas speak about a movement initiated by Bomjon, by the order to his followers, to throw out Buddhist statues and Buddhist books from the temples of Buddha all over the villages. He's very careful to do it, to this destruction of Buddhism, on a very low profile level, so that there is not any international affair about it, then the government doesn't care about it, because it's just, you know, village level. Obviously, as soon as Bomjon would just come to Bodhanath and throw out the statues from the main Bodhanath monasteries, then there would be a big deal about it. But because he is doing cleverly all his work, destructive work, on a very low profile level and amongst the weakest and poorest societies. It means the poor Tamang villages, which have collected money to make Buddhist temples from their little savings, and they pay some little fee for a local Tamang Lama to maintain the main pujas, the main rituals, and usually, as in every society, the religion is important for people, for the birth of children, and when people die, the cremation rituals, etc. And then suddenly Bomjon's blue robed monks come there, they throw out the statues and burn the books, the holy books, this kind of long Tibetan written holy books of Buddhism. They replace the Buddha statues by Bomjon's photos, and they tell the illiterate and very weak villagers, you have to worship him. Of course, many villagers are against this, because this is a desecration of the Buddhist Dharma, the Buddhist temple, and even Gautama Buddha's name So many locals are terrified from this movement and the level of Nepali villages. But the government doesn't care, because when did the government in Nepal care about the poorest and weakest people who have no money to bribe them? Never. Yeah, if they care, then there are no earthquake victims still without accommodation today. So Bomjon knows in which level and in which area he can be the only authority. And paying bribes to the local municipalities, they can do many things what the local people have no power to protest against. And so we have now, I have managed to translate until now only three Buddhist lamas into English, this and this and this video. You can check in my channel and listen to what they are saying. At least two of these lamas had been serving Bomjon personally, because they believed innocently and ignorantly, like I believed in the first years that he was meditating. They also believed that he was a serious spiritual person, that he was searching enlightenment, and he was doing all this for the benefit of sentient beings, like Gautama Buddha did. But very soon they realized that it's something very different. It's something very different in a negative way. And many of them just soon distanced themselves from Bomjon. And I am translating what they are saying, so I'm not going to repeat it in this video. You can check it in these videos with the lamas themselves and listen to what they say. But I just pick out these two important things, which two lamas from different community are saying the same thing. One of them is Prem Dorje Lama, who is from the community of the now deceased Gyansagar Rinpoche of Daune. It's a famous Rinpoche who was also having many speeches in the Nepali radio, and he was promoting vegetarianism in Buddhism, and he made a movement of vegetarian monasteries all over Nepal. And actually my Simra friends, the only people who, though somehow connected with Bomjon, the only people who were behaving morally and nicely to me, were actually former, or that time still followers of Gyansaga Rinpoche, the vegetarian famous Rinpoche of Daune. And this Prem Dorje Lama, who is speaking out against Bomjon and against Bomjon's apparently kidnapping, raping, and maybe killing two nuns, this Prem Dorje Lama was also around Bomjon in the beginning, helping him, supporting him, and trying to introduce him into Buddhism and introduce Buddhists into him. So these lamas were trying to connect the wild jungle Bomjon, who had no education, no knowledge, no behavior. They tried to somehow combine Bomjon with classical traditional Buddhism, but they always failed, because Bomjon was not behaving morally. He was keeping girlfriends from the very beginning, or before 2009 already. Mumbai, Chennai, Lamai, Josun, Mumbai.
Bombay,